वेलकम चिल्ड्रेन, वेरी वॉर्म वेलकम। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट योर प्लेसेस। सो टुडे दिस इज आवर ईएसटी एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज क्लास। व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी? एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज। एंड यू नो दैट वी आर ऑन social studies book. We are studying our first chapter from this book, New Getting Ahead in Social Studies, and we are studying chapter first, The Globe, a Model of Earth. In earlier class the geographer divides the earth on smaller scale for study into two parts, map and globe. Then we study what is globe. A globe is a small model of earth. Then we studied the earth rotation, the axis of earth on which the earth rotate. It is tilted 23.5 or 23.5 degree. We study about the North Pole and South Pole, and we also study about the hemisphere, the types of hemispheres. Okay children, now we will continue with this chapter, and I hope you all have done the homework which I have given to you to do in your notebooks. Now we have latitude and longitude. See, whenever you have seen the globe, there is lines like this. So these lines are called latitudes and longitude. Why latitude and longitude are used? To locate places on the globe, horizontal and vertical lines are drawn. What is the need of longitude and latitude? The earth is divided into lots of imaginary lines called latitude and longitude. I will show you. See children, this is the globe. See, there are lots of lines. Are you able to see? Yes. What is the meaning of these lines? These lines are called latitudes and longitudes. Why these lines are made? From these lines, means these longitude and latitudes, help us to locate the place on globe. Okay? See, this is latitude. And equator is also in this way. So, horizontal lines are drawn parallel to equator is called latitude or parallels. The horizontal lines drawn on earth, and these lines are parallel to each other, they are called, and also parallel to the equator, so they are called latitudes. Now, longitude. Longitudes are the vertical lines which forms semicircle that run from one pole to another. As you can see, they are moving like this. From one pole to another. Longitudes are the vertical lines. Longitude are the vertical lines form semicircle that can run from one pole to another. From north pole to south pole. As there are two poles, north pole and south pole, so the vertical lines drawn on the globe is called longitude, and these lines run between the two poles, that is north pole to south pole. And longitudes are also called meridians. Longitudes are also called meridians. And these longitude and latitudes are marked in degree and minutes. 60 minutes is equal to 1 degree. They are marked in degrees and minutes. And 60 minutes is equal to 1 degree. All right. Now, latitudes and longitudes coordinate system by means of which the position or location of any place. The position and location of any place on Earth's surface can be determined and described. With the help of longitude and latitude, we can find the position or the location of any place on Earth's surface. See, this is North Pole and this is North Pole and this is South Pole. Few degrees are mentioned here in this way, in longitude also and latitude also. And the equator is at zero. We can easily find out the place with the help of latitude and longitude, wherever the degree and minutes, we can easily find the place on the Earth surface. And these are longitudes. So the middle line is called prime meridian. The center line of the longitude called prime meridian. And the middle line of latitude called equator. What does it call? It called equator. See the picture of equator? The picture of the Earth. North Pole, South Pole. And this middle line is equator. And few degrees are mentioned. But equator is at 0 degree. Equator is at 0 degree. What is latitude? It is an imaginary and horizontal line drawn parallel to equator, which run east to west on Earth's surface, are called latitude. Latitude lines run from east to west. It runs from It run from east to west. All the lines are drawn like this. These are the horizontal lines. Imaginary horizontal line drawn parallel to equator. What are parallels? Parallel lines which do not meet each other. Parallel means the lines which do not meet each other. So this is an imaginary line or horizontal line drawn parallel to the equator which run east to west on Earth's surface are called latitudes. How we mark latitude on the surface? Marking of latitude. The equator marked 0. See in the picture. The equator is marked 0. The North Pole and the South Pole is having 90 degrees. The North Pole and South Pole is having 90 degrees. The North Pole is 90 degrees north and the South Pole is 90 degrees south. Thus, latitude of the place tells you how far north or south a place is from equator. Means equator has 0 and North Pole is 90 degrees and South Pole is also 90 degrees. So, the latitude tells you how far the north or the south is from the equator. Understood? Equator is at 0 degree, North Pole 90 degree, South Pole also is at 90 degree. And equator is a middle line. Now features. There are some features also. Features of latitude. Runs parallel to each other in east and west direction. As you have seen in the picture, the lines are parallel to each other and it runs from east to west direction. Equal distance from others. Each line is having equal distance. All of them form complete circle. All the lines which is drawn forms complete circle except north and south pole, because they are the endpoints. Decrease the length as you move from equator to the pole. See in the picture. The distance between the two lines are equal. Okay? And these lines forms circle. Okay? And except at poles. And it decreases, and when you go away either towards North Pole or towards South Pole, the size decreases. The last point is decrease in length means the length of the circle decreases as you move from equator to the pole. Now we have longitude. See the picture first. North Pole, South Pole, and here also on these lines some degrees are given, some degrees are mentioned, and the middle line of the longitude is called prime meridian. It is also at 0 degree. It is also at 0 degree. So longitude is an invisible vertical line. See, these are vertical lines around the earth from north to south. Longitude are also an invisible lines. These are vertical lines which run around the earth, and these lines runs between the North Pole and the South Pole. Now the marking of longitude. Running through The old Royal Observatory at Greenwich Meridian near London is marked zero. As in latitude, it is equator, it is marked zero. Here, the longitude running through the old Royal Observatory at Greenwich Meridian near London is marked zero. There are 360 degree of longitude means 180 degree east to the prime meridian and 180 degree west to the prime meridian. Prime meridian or Greenwich is same. The degree is 360 degree means 360 degree to the east and 180 degree to the east and 180 degree to the west of prime meridian, as prime meridian marked zero. So prime meridian divides the longitude into two parts, means 180 degree east and 180 degree west. 180 degree east and 180 degree west longitude meets and forms single line on opposite side of the world called international date line. As you know that at one time you can only see the one side of the globe of the earth. For the other side you have to rotate it. So 180 degree east and 180 degree west longitude meet and form single line on opposite side, means the side which is not visible, that is the opposite side of the world, and that is called international date line. What it is called? International date line. Where? On the opposite side of the world. It has 360 degree, 180 degree east and 180 degree west. Greenwich Meridian marked zero. Greenwich Meridian marked zero. Now longitude, see, here also few degrees are mentioned. This is prime meridian and this is marked zero. Longitude of the place tells you how much east and west of the Greenwich located. Longitude of the place tells you how much east and west of the Greenwich or prime meridian. Now we have features of longitude. The lines are semicircle that run from one pole to another, from north pole to south pole. They run in north and south direction. They are spaced farthest apart at the equator and come together to the point at the pole. Latitude and longitude cut each other at right angle. See, it says that this is equator line, for example. So the space between the two lines is far, near the equator, means they are far from each other. The lines are far from each other at equator. See, and when it goes up or when it goes down towards the pole, the size decrease. See, the space become less, the size decrease. And these are latitudes and these are longitude. So longitude and latitude cut each other at right angle. Cut each other at right angle. That is at the angle of 90 degree. It runs from north to south. from North Pole to South Pole. Now children, the last one is global grid. Global grid. The latitude and longitude together form a network of lines or grid on the globe. This is known as global grid. Means latitude and longitudes form a network. See with the help of picture. See, these are the lines. Latitude and longitude, both the lines are here. So this is looking like a lines of network or grid. Okay. The latitude and longitude together form a network of lines or grid on the globe. This is known as global grid. See once again. What is global grid? The latitude and longitude forms the lines or forms the network of lines or grid on the globe. This is called global grid. I hope you all have understood what we have studied today. Today we have studied the first chapter of New Getting Ahead Towards Social Studies, Chapter 1,